Begin by coming into your body and finding a position that feels comfortable for you. Maybe it's sitting in a chair or on a cushion. Maybe it's lying down. In any case, allow your body to get comfortable. Notice what that comfort feels like in your body. How is it that you know that comfort is present? Where do you feel it? What does it feel like? Explore those sensations in your body and allow yourself to enjoy them. Notice if there's any muscular tension that's present for you at this time. Scanning your body to look for tightness. If you find that your muscles are tense anywhere in your body, gently invite them to relax, to loosen, to let go. Of course, your muscles may or may not be able or willing to relax at this time. Or you might relax them and they might become tight again. Simply set the intention to relax as much as is possible. To establish yourself in that relaxation. And to enjoy it. Again, notice what these sensations of relaxation are like. Where they are and how they feel. Really experience the pleasure of relaxation, even if it's small. If you'd like, if it feels good for you, you can invite a gentle, easy smile to your face. Just a simple smile. Doesn't have to be a huge grin. In this way, allowing your physical body to incline your mind and your experience towards happiness. Just smiling. Notice what this feels like in your body. Be comfortable and relaxed. The gentle, easy smile on your face. Without losing these qualities in the body, begin to involve the mind. See if there are any phrases that you can tell yourself verbally in your mind. It might be loving for you to hear. Perhaps the same phrase over and over again, or many different phrases. Something like, I love you so much. I'll do anything I can to take care of you. I see how hard you're trying. I'm proud of you. You know yourself best. Tell yourself whatever would be loving for you to hear. If any emotions or sensations of warmth or love or care for yourself arise, if you feel loved by yourself, again, notice that and really enjoy it. Soak those experiences up. continue to practice loving yourself in this way for another moment. Very good. Now, take a moment to cultivate love for your easy to love person or animal, whoever that might be for you, perhaps a friend or family member, small child or pet, or even someone imaginary. Someone who's relatively easy for you to feel love for, who you have a simple relationship with. Begin to cultivate love for them in a similar way, using mental talk in your mind. Again, you could use the same phrase over and over again, or many different phrases. Love you so much. Want you to be so happy. May you be safe and healthy. I hope you feel my love. Whatever words resonate for you. Say those in your mind. Whatever phrase or phrases you're saying, be sure that you can hear them in your mind. Using mental talk as a method to cultivate love for your easy to love person or animal. And again, if any feelings of love or warmth, friendliness arise for you in your body, if you feel love, notice that and deeply savor it. Be nourished by this love. fueled by it. In a moment, we'll transition into the main practice. If any feelings of love for yourself or your easy to love person or animal have entered your body, see if you can maintain that love, keeping it nearby, as if it were a roof over your head or a blanket to keep you warm. Something that you can return to. Consider if there is something in your life, someone or some situation that could use a sense of forgiveness. Some difficult situation that's been hurtful for you or challenging. It doesn't need to be the most painful thing in your life, although you can work with that if you choose. Just something difficult is fine. Even something small and ordinary. We're going to steer towards forgiveness, knowing that that's a wholesome healing quality to cultivate. It gives us psychological ease and happiness and interpersonal peace. Before we do that, take a moment to really honor. Notice your experience of this hurt. What it is that is asking for forgiveness. Really acknowledging your experience and your understanding of what's transpired and validating that for yourself. Yes, that did happen. Yes, that did hurt. It helps you can use mental talk, as we did previously, to tell yourself a story about what happened. Really feel it. Feel the impact that this situation had on you. Any feelings of anger or sadness, hurt come up for you, allow those feelings to move through your body, not making them bad, welcoming them instead, allowing them, knowing that fully feeling our feelings is an important part of the healing process. Having connected to this situation and your experience of it, use your intuition and your creativity to see if there's any way you might steer towards forgiveness. You could imagine someone apologizing to you and how you might respond to that. You might simply say, "I forgive you." Using that as a phrase, as a door to forgiveness. Perhaps you can use your heart and your body to directly connect to a felt sense of forgiveness, relinquishment, and ease. Allow yourself to experiment and play, to try and to test. See if there's some way you can steer towards forgiveness. This proves difficult, you can always ease off and return to cultivating love for yourself or your easy to love person or animal. And if, on the other hand, you can connect to a sense of forgiveness, again, use this basic skill of noticing and enjoying that experience. Delighting in it, celebrating it. Whatever your experience is, there's a skillful way to work with it. Very good. Now, look back on this practice period. Recall what your experience was like. See if there are any lessons that you might discern from your experience. Anything that could be useful to you in a future practice period. As you're ready, at your own pace, you can come out of the meditation.